This week there's cancellation, graduations, and also surprise announcements. I'm Mr. Josh Pucks, and this is the AKB48 Group News of the Week. If this is your first time watching, you can go ahead and go on the top right of the screen to see what section you're on, whether it's 48, graduated, or 46, as well as a community section. So starting off, I want to give you guys a fair warning that I won't be talking about Jankin this time. I'll talk about it when it actually happens. I feel like if I talk about the little details too much, I feel like it'll get a little bit complicated and I'd rather just do a big wrap up at the end. So that's where we are on that situation. So first up is about Stu48 actually announcing a tour. So from September 9th all the way to the 25th of November, Stu48 is actually going to hold their tour for 7 different prefectures. And somebody replied back to a comment I made on this news on Twitter, and pretty funny replies. Here's 2 that I saw. So with this, I imagine it'll be interesting to see them live and actually perform in their own tour. So I kind of wonder what kind of songs they're going to play for a tour. It's mostly going to be AKB, I imagine, maybe their single that they have or other songs like that, because they don't really have an itinerary of a lot of songs. But next we're going to talk about NGT48 and how for the first single, they're actually going to release it in a different edition, and that's vinyl edition. I was actually talking about this last time on Twitter, where AKB hasn't uploaded their video in 4K, even though Stu48 has, and how they're behind in the times, and how they should just give everyone VHS tapes and vinyls. And actually, they're going to release vinyls for NGT. So if you're into collectibles and stuff like that, I definitely recommend checking that out on the 27th of September. Next up, we have Sashi Hararino, you know, the ever popular, always on TV. Well, she's on TV again, and this time for a commercial. It's for the mobile game Pocket Colony. I don't know much about this. It's like a dress up kind of game, but in this commercial, she's actually advertising towards 20 and 30 year old women. So check that out in the link below. It's an interesting watch to see her actually perform with other people in one of the commercials, and in the commercials, she's just laying down and just playing the game. Next up, we're gonna talk about Riripon and how she actually apologized for her marriage announcement. During the final concert of the NMB Live, she actually went up and actually apologized to everyone. She apologizes for causing harm to any fans, staff members, and even members. And she even admitted that it hurt NMB a little, and she's an awkward person, so she thought this was the best way, but apparently it wasn't. And something that I really liked is Kinoshita Momoka, who is actually going to graduate, as I talked about last week, did mention something afterwards about how you should mention how you love NMB48 and focus less on apologizing. So it's great to see her speak up and kind of give her input on this. And it's a really cool watch if you could find that video. Next up, I'm gonna talk about graduated members. And let's start with Oshima Yuko, who's actually doing a collaboration with Hulu. WOWOW and Hulu Japan are actually doing a new drama called Kote de Azur and Degree 10. That's a complicated name. But it will be a 9-episode drama, and from the look of it, it looks like it will be episodic because they will be playing different characters every episode. So 5 of the episodes will be on WOWOW and 4 will be on Hulu Japan. So it'll be interesting to see like what everyone does, especially since it's episodic. Maybe the last 4 go on Hulu, or maybe the best 4 go on Hulu because they pay more. I don't know exactly how it is, but I'm excited to see Oshima Yuko and other stuff. And that actually begins November 2017, so keep an eye out for that. Next up, we have Takahashi Minami, the ex-general manager of AKB48, and she's releasing her 2nd solo single, as I've talked about before, but we finally have the artwork for it. To me, the cover kind of looks kind of simplistic, kind of a little bit run-of-the-mill, to be honest. You could tell there was some organization to it, but it feels like kind of every other cover there. So nothing too big on the covers, so I guess next person. Next up, I talked about last week how Watanabe Miyuki is going to have a birthday celebration. Well, that was canceled. Apparently the agency decided to cancel it themselves. I don't know what the reason could be or what the situations were, but there must have been a reason, and hopefully it's a good reason. Next up is about Nakamura Mariko, who I actually haven't talked about before, as far as I remember. But she will actually be in a new news program. It is for Sun TV News, and it actually started airing already, so you can go ahead and check her out if you were a fan of her. And next up is news I'm excited for, and that's a new photo book from another graduated member, and that is Takajo Aki, the girl who has a YouTube channel as well, and who's kind of sparingly uploading. But with Kobunsha, she will actually release it in October 2017. So that's coming up pretty soon. That's how many months away? Like 2 months away. So expect that to come out. I'm kind of excited for this. I might pick this one up. And next, let's go to 46 side, starting with Nogizaka 46 and their first day sales for Nigemizu. So the first day sales were 716,197 copies, ranking at number one. Now comparing that to last single, it's actually 743,000. So they actually dropped a little bit, but this might be because of the new centers that are fresh. Nobody knows them yet. This might be because of the song. This might be different variables. But I imagine the new centers have something to do with it. Which means if they have solid centers next single, it could get boosted up again and pass the previous single. And hopefully reaching that one day million mark on the first day. And next up we have another photo book surprise, and that's with Yoda Yuki of all members. I mean, she's actually the first member who isn't a first generation member to actually get a photo book. You know, other than Ki-chan that was supposed to come out June, but that never happened. And it's still kind of in a mystery kind of thing. Until now, because I did see that, let me see his name. His name is Toru Kenjo, who's the chief executive officer of Gintosha. He actually said that, yes, Ki-chan and Yoda, he will try his best for both. Or specifically, he said, Ki-chan to Yoda-chan no shashinshu ganbarimasu. So this news was actually revealed to her in Miyagi during the national tour. And she was super surprised, and apparently production is going to start immediately, so I imagine like right after the tours, they're gonna go wherever and take those pictures. And I mean, they might even include some from the actual tour just to speed things up. But it is still to be announced date, so we don't know when we could get an estimate. I don't know if they'll release Ki-chan and Yoda's at the same time. I wonder how that would pan out, seeing the second and third gen come out near the same time at least, and seeing how the sales are with them. Because I mean, Yoda Yuki is fairly popular in Japan. She like sells out in handshakes all the time. Her photos sell for expensive. She's up there with the top members. So it should be interesting to see. And don't even get me started about how they're prioritizing Yoda Yuki over Ki-chan, whose photo book has already been taken and really is just need to be printed and released. So it's a whole big deal. I feel like they should set their priorities right, and if they say they're gonna release at this day, then it should be released on this day, or in this case month. But hopefully we get that Ki-chan photo book and we get that Yoda Yuki photo book. I probably will buy both anyway. And there's an official link down below of the Twitter of Yoda Yuki's photo book, so you can go ahead and check that out. Next up is a little bit of sad news, and that's a graduation from a Nogizaka member. Oh, it's the worst because there's so few members, so when one person graduates, it's a big impact. And especially with this member, because it's Nakamoto Himeka, aka Hime-tan. She announced it during Rajira, which is a radio show she's on. And even though there is no official date when she will graduate, she will not actually participate in the national tour. She will participate in an Under Live, but generally she's not going to go on the tour. And being someone who always wanted to be an idol, I remember in the old Nogizaka show, how when she was little, she was even dancing, wanting to be an idol. And that's really what I remember her by. And now she's announcing graduation and actually retirement from show business in general. Coming from a hiatus and doing a little bit of work, maybe she realized she can't really keep up with how she used to be. And since she's not in tip-top condition, she can't really go on at her best. Because I feel like Hime-tan is one of those who wants to do everything right. And if she can't do it right, then I mean, you can't do it right, right? So super sad to see her go. And especially graduating from show business, we have another Nanami over here. But hopefully life goes well for her, as I hope for everyone, really. But she's leaving, but new people are coming in on Kiyakizaka. And that's the new audition people for Hiragana Kiyakizaka. They did do showroom this week, and they actually revealed some of the photos. Some of the other photos didn't get revealed, really. But if you were on in showroom or follow me on Twitter, retweeting some stuff, then you'll be able to see that some members had a lot of potential. People who interested me were number 11 and number 12. Even though number 12 didn't have her face shown, her personality really shone just through her voice. Kind of sounded like Oda Nana a little, people were saying, but really showed through. Especially she had a recorder and she had a guitar, she was singing. All of it was good, really. And people seemed to really latch onto her. Number 11 as well, guitar, singing, and a lot of potential. I tried to watch number 23, but the picture deceived me, and then when I saw the video, I was like, not really feeling this. So it sounds kind of blunt, but yeah, I didn't really feel it. Number 7, 15, and 18 also look good. I didn't really watch the rest. I kind of just like glimpsed at them, and then I was going to watch them, but then I had to work, and I ended up just watching 11 and 12 mostly. But it seems like there will be a lot of potential with them, so I'm excited to see what the future holds for them. Next up is community section, where I talk about cool things people do in the community this week, or even cool people that I want to talk about. First person I want to talk about is someone I found on SoundCloud, and they actually did a almost 1 hour version of all the Kiyakizaka songs all put into those 50 minutes. It's really cool if you want to just hear Kiyakizaka for 15 minutes straight and all in a medley sounding cool. So you can go ahead and check out Yasuo003 down in the description below. Follow them on Twitter or check them out on SoundCloud. And next person I want to talk about is K-Sair, who I've actually talked about before. You can go ahead and check out his Twitter down in the description below. But something cool that's happening is a translation of everything from Kiyakise, which is the mobile game I've talked about before. And actually, it's a daily translation of what the official Twitter releases. So if you want to know a little bit more about the game, and know it in English because you don't speak Japanese like me, then go ahead and check that out down below. If you missed last week, you can go ahead and check that out in my video section. And again, you can subscribe to keep up to date with the news. Go ahead and share it to your friends so they can keep up with the news in video form. And you can also go ahead and share with other people who you think might like the channel or the video in general. Don't forget to leave those comments down below about anything about the video or just in general. And once again, thank you all for watching.